Hey, Riddle here. Welcome back to my channel. It's January 7th-ish, and we are in the Santa Cruz Mountains. I'm on my property right now, and we've had several days of rain, and we've had the weekend off from rain, and we've been out mushroom hunting. Everyone's intrigued by wild mushroom hunting. And you know, I want to remind you, when in doubt, do without. But this is one of those tried and true mushrooms that are really easy to identify. And if you cut them carefully, they will grow back on the log year after year until the log disintegrates. This, my friends, is an incredible specimen of wild oyster mushroom. You can tell from how it fans out. Often they'll grow straight up and down like a totem pole, sometimes higher than you can reach. Luckily this time this has fallen down and broken off of another point from up here. And see the stump up there? That's where I found my first colony that I've been keeping an eye on. And I carefully cut them and they grew back the second rain about 6 weeks later. So I am going to take my knife now and remove these carefully from the stump so they grow back. And this is going to be dinner. You can also dehydrate these and they rehydrate beautifully, or you can dehydrate them really, really well and make them into a powder, and you can get that awesome flavor and consume, you know, all the mushroom, because it's going to be in a soup or a stew or a gravy or a smoothie, however you use it. All mushrooms have anti-cancer benefits and incredible nutrition, including quite a bit of protein. So keep mushrooming and don't pick more than you need. That's the big mistake. People get all monkey on this stuff and they'll pick every single one and they don't know what it is. So basically they have to throw it all away, or they pick it all and it rots in their garage. Be responsible when wildcrafting. You know, these are living things, and if we're gonna have them in the future for our children or children's children, we have to steward them and care for them. So that means taking only what you need or what you can manage, and when you're removing them properly, which is simply just cutting them away from the log instead of tearing them off the log. That's it. If you enjoy my quick informative videos, please join, it helps. Take care of yourselves, and I hope you have the most incredible 2018. Take care.